Welcome back. 6:53, time for the morning sprint.
Another vaccine clinic will open up today. Greene County Public Health will host one at the county's government services building in Monroe. It runs from 9 till 2 today. Healthcare workers will administer the Moderna vaccine here. Greene County residents 65 and older can make an appointment for the clinic online. No walk-ins today. The county hosted its first clinic earlier this week.
The Alliant Energy Center could become a federal vaccination site. Right now, the center is able to vaccinate up to 600 people a day. That number could grow to 6,000 if the federal government picks the center. Dane County Executive Joe Parisi says county leaders have applied to be the 100th regional vaccination site in the country. That decision could be made within the next few weeks.
A sad update to a story we brought you yesterday. The grandmother heard in a house explosion in River Falls has died. Crews are still working to figure out what caused the explosion. People down the street say the blast was so powerful that it opened up their cupboard doors. A neighbor says the grandmother's daughter was also in the home, but her injuries are not as severe. New video here, an alleged armed driver led LA police officers in an hours-long chase overnight. At one point, the driver started driving in the wrong side of the road and then slowed down to a crawl. Police believe the driver is possibly wanted in connection to a shooting.
This is a live look now at the Capitol, where the police officer killed by rioters during the insurrection last month is lying in honor. Members of Congress can attend the viewing this morning. The president and first lady paid their respects last night. Brian Sicknick's cremated remains will lie in honor until his burial at Arlington National Cemetery later today. He was 42 years old.
UW-Madison's Arboretum is now recognized as a National Historic Landmark. The National Park Service and the Secretary of the Interior approved the designation. The Arboretum was created back in the 30s as an outdoor lab to study how to repair damaged landscapes. Those early experiments helped create a better understanding of local ecosystems and develop restoration and management practices.
UW-Madison will have some representation in an upcoming episode of Jeopardy! Lance St. Laurent is a film student at UW. He says after the months-long process of testing and interviews, he was finally invited to compete. He can't say what happened on set, but we can watch for ourselves when his episode airs next Friday. We have more on his journey and experience on the show up right now on channel3000.com.
You'll enjoy a lovely commute out there today. No issues are expected in the world of travel delays, not for your morning commute nor your evening commute, but this changes as we move into tomorrow. Winter storm watches have been issued for pretty much all of southern Wisconsin. Ahead of that next storm system, we'll wake up tomorrow morning with light freezing rain and sleet. By lunchtime, heavy snow should take over for all of us, and that'll likely take us all the way into the evening and the early overnight time period. It is zero in Madison right now, but we'll gradually begin to warm things up under sunny skies into the upper 20s. We may be going off the air, but we are not disconnected. Have the weather on the go. Download our app from the App Store. We'll post videos and updates as the storm inches closer. You can also follow us on social media. I'll be keeping you up to date all morning long.
All right. Thanks, Chris. Thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you tomorrow.